Discussion of the front of the arm. We reflect the skin of the front of the arm. This one is a brown color. It is the superficial fascia, and we reflect the skin of the front of the arm. We have already reflected the deep fascia of the front of the arm, and this deep fascia here in on that side. Here you can see this is the fatty layer. This is the fatty layer. Yellowish color and brownish color are the fatty layer, and this one is the deep fascia which is covered on the posterior aspect. But in front side we have removed the deep fascia, and this deep fascia which divides, it gives the two intermuscular septum, and it divides the arm into the two compartment. This is the medial intermuscular septum, and this one is the lateral intermuscular septum which divides the front of the arm arm into the two compartment. Anterior compartment, it is called the flexor compartment, and posterior compartment, only one muscle, it is formed by the tricep muscles. In previous lecture we already discussed the pectoralis major, pectoralis minor, and reflect the all the muscles. Now we will discuss about the muscles of the front of the arm. Muscles of the front of the arm, first muscle, it is the coracobrachialis. This is the coracobrachialis muscle. This coracobrachialis arise from the coracoid process of the scapula.
Go.
Coracobrachialis, which arise from the tip of the coracoid process, and it is inserted on the upper half of the medial side of the humerus, and it is pierced by the musculocutaneous nerve. And this musculocutaneous nerve pierces to the coracobrachialis, and it supplies to the muscles of the front, all the muscles of the front of the arm, which is supplied by the musculocutaneous. And this musculocutaneous, it is the branch of lateral cord, and it becomes continuous as a lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm along with the cephalic vein, and it supplies to the skin over the lateral side of the front of the lateral side of the arm. Another thing, another muscle, it is the biceps. It has a two head, and this biceps has a short head which is along with the coracoid process of the scapula along with the coracobrachialis, and long head of the biceps which is arise from the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula, and it is inserted on the radial tuberosity on the radius, and it superficial part, it is inserted into the deep fascia of the front of the arm. It is called the bicipital aponeurosis. Third muscles, which is the brachialis, it is the deep muscles, and brachialis which is arise from the anteromedial surface and anterolateral surface of the lower half of the humerus, and it is inserted on the coracoid process, and the most prominent part of the coracoid process, it is called the ulnar tuberosity. Of the ulna, coracoid process of the ulna, it is the insertion of the brachialis muscles. So biceps and brachialis muscles, both are the chief flexor of the elbow joints. Another thing, this is the brachial artery. Brachial artery, it is the continuation of the axillary artery at the lower border of the teres major, and it is divided into the inside the cuboidal fossa, it divided into the radial artery and ulnar artery. So the brachial artery, it gives the first branch. This is the first branch along with the radial nerve. It enter inside the lower triangular space, and above it is bounded by the teres major. Below, medially it is bounded by the longer of triceps, and laterally it is bounded by the shaft of humerus. On that way you can see here, this way, this is the teres major, this is the teres major muscles, and medially you can see this muscle, it is the longer of triceps, and laterally there is a shaft of the humerus, and this radial nerve, along with it there is a profunda brachii artery which is passed, and this profunda brachii inside the radial groove, it gives the two branches. On the left, it is the artery for the posterior compartment, and it gives the two branches, anterior descending and posterior descending. Another artery, branches of the brachial artery, it gives the nutrient branches, it gives the muscular branches, it gives the superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral. This is a superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral artery. This is a muscular branch of the brachial artery, and in this body there is a higher division of the brachial artery. This is the smaller one, it goes laterally, and this is the radial artery, and this one is the larger one, it is passed on the medial side, and this is the ulnar artery. Normally inside the cuboidal fossa, the structure from medial to lateral are the median nerve, the brachial artery, but in this case it is the higher division, so both artery are divided. So median nerve, brachial artery, then biceps tendon, and then the superficial division of the radial nerve. This is the superficial division of the radial nerve. But in this case, the most medially, there is ulnar artery, then median nerve, then biceps tendon, then radial nerve, a radial artery, and then radial nerve, superficial division of radial nerve inside the cuboidal fossa. In this case, normally it is the medial to lateral are the structure inside the cuboidal fossa, median nerve, brachial artery, biceps tendon, and superficial division of the radial nerve. So this is about to the branches of the brachial artery. Once again, this is the first branch of the brachial artery. It is the profunda brachii. It is along with the radial nerve inside the lower triangular space. Another nutrient artery, and there are two branches, superficial and superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral artery, and these are the muscular branches, and this is the higher division of the radial artery and ulnar artery. This is the radial artery and this one is the ulnar artery. Normally this median nerve, which crosses from lateral to medial side to the brachial artery inside the front of the arm, so inside the cuboidal fossa, most medial structure, it is a median nerve, you have to remember.